thousand ones in an hour. I'ma make it stretch. I just made a mess. I just made a mess. I got cash by the bundle, so I'll never press. I just made a mess. I just made a mess.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to the Carolinas and Bank of America Stadium here in Uptown Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerge from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Atlanta Falcons. First 2 months of the regular season down. What will the final two bring us as we're off in week 9? And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
So, Charles, you look at this offense, and really on paper at least, a great situation for them upcoming. They're unbeaten on the year, an open week coming up after this. So I guess my question, any worry that maybe this is coming at the wrong time?
Oh, definitely I would be worried about this game, maybe more than any other on the schedule, because I know my guys are looking ahead to that open week. I've got to keep them focused on the task ahead, make sure they take care of business in this one. Otherwise, you're talking about a double trap, the trap of losing the game and then having the open week and having to stew about it.
And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. These two teams met up earlier in the year back in week 4, and it was the visiting Panthers who came away with the victory in that one. So now they look to take the season series here at home in Charlotte. Second and 8. They'll set up a throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. That catch good for 5. It's third down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
To throw now on first down. His throw caught at about the 5. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about 3.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive, and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise...
And he will take it across for Panthers touchdown. A great effort there. His 11th touchdown of the year. And the Panthers take it right down and score on the opening drive. No going for 2. They'll kick the point after. And this will be good to give the Panthers a 7-0 lead.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Taking it about the one. And he'll get this just up past the 20, but a marker is down. Let's get the call. Well, that holding call set him up with not great field position.
Not at all when you tack on the penalty. But that field position after the return wasn't terrific. It's not a great starting field position as well.
From the gun, they'll try to run it. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Open man is Goddard, the tight end. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. Let's see what kind of mindset they have here. Offensively, after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so our offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
But I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Well, these two teams, they met in Charlotte earlier in the year with the Panthers coming out on top. So a win here in Charlotte would give them the season sweep.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete.
Well, this defense for the Panthers, they were terrific a week ago in that victory over Tampa Bay, Charles.
And as in any game, takeaways are always a big key. They're always discussed on defense. There's an emphasis there. And they came away with three interceptions in that game.
And that will be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. And they'll let this one go right on the outskirts of the 10. They'll down it at the 11-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive.
here at the halfway point of the season, Charles. 8-0. What a great start. Clearly a Super Bowl contender, if not the outright favorite. Oh, into a sea of defenders had intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it. Then he will bring it back to about the 11-yard line. Well, Charles, that's now four interceptions over his last three halves of football, because remember, he threw three picks last week.
Starting to wonder if maybe defenses and those coordinators have identified something on tape with what he's doing. Maybe a movement, maybe the way he's moving his shoulders. Who knows what it could be? He could have a few tells out there that they're keying in on and allowing defenses to get to the football a little bit faster. People steal signals. Maybe sometimes they can figure out what the quarterback's doing just by his movements.
And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it.
And he's only hit on two of his first six passes. Time for a quick quarterback regroup here with a big third down coming up.
So they've been unable to capitalize on a great field position as of yet. Here's third and nine. This to Pitts, and he's got him. Touchdown, Atlanta. Kyle Pitts, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game. Extra point right down the middle. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. So all even at seven now as they kick it away. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Second and six. Got an open man here, and it's K.J. Hamler. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. To throw. And he will find his man on the end route. Complete. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Now this will probably be the last play of the quarter. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about five. These two teams all tied after one. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. And they will finally get him down as he's all the way to the 36-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by J.C. Horn. And the Panthers are going to get it back here just shy of the 20. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And two interceptions already here in this first half. That's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Touchdown, Carolina. Yeah, he's been doing this for a lot of years, and the arm strength still there, and he showed it off on that one. Extra point splits the uprights, and that makes the score 14-7. Zach now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And a mistake, a surprising mistake there in the kicking game as he sends that one out of bounds. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 40. And here's a handoff out of the gun. And a penalty flag down as he gets only about a yard. And let's listen in on the call. That hold coming from the middle of the line, the center.
And it's difficult for him because sometimes you've got people right over you, and as soon as you snap it, trying to get your hands up to block them, you can be a little bit late getting it done.
Back to throw. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Jeremy Chin picks it off. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. This defense had three interceptions last week. They're on pace for more than that here. Two in the first half.
Do not adjust your set. This is not instant replay. This is a defense that is locked in. They're essentially running the routes for the receivers and turning into the receivers themselves, aren't they? I mean, it is amazing what I'm seeing because the reactions of those guys back on the back seven, phenomenal.
Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. Now the ball comes loose, and the Falcons grab it. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football, and they still find ways to knock it free.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely. Great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Another example right there how this defense really is winning the entire game at the point of attack.
Yeah, right there at the line of scrimmage because they are dominating it. It allows their interior guys to get upfield and spill into the backfield. So how are you going to combat that? You know, because they bring in your tight end.
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by J.C. Horn. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown. The try here for the extra point. It's good, and it is now 21-7. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back
in. But they told him, and they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. And they give this time to the tailback. And he'll get across midfield and into Carolina territory. It's a 5-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with third down now looming.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Jeremy Chin picks it off.
And a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line.
Well, we heard all week that they were going to put the football in the air a lot. The problem is that is now four interceptions, Charles, that he has thrown in this first half. How do you treat a situation? What do you say to your quarterback right now?
Boy, that's an interesting question because a lot of it depends on the head coach and the people making the decisions. You have to know your quarterback and know if he's mentally tough enough to have a chance to turn it around. Or is he a guy that maybe you've seen enough and it's time to go to the backup? But right now what you're rooting for is your defense to help keep you in the game, to give him an opportunity to get back on track.
And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. First down, he'll drop to throw. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it. And the Falcons are going to have it here just past the 25.
Boy, that's the kind of interception that could save a game right there. They're already down two scores. Huge play slowing down what was going against them.
I was thinking the same thing. You get down three scores there at this stage, could be in for a long ball game.
Throwing here to start the drive as they connect left side. And he's brought down after a very nice gain.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half, but I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. They're going to look to throw.
And he's just throwing the ball up for grabs now. Fortunately, that one going to fall incomplete. I hate to say it, Charles, but the way that he has played in this first half, you just kind of hold your breath every time he drops back to pass.
Yeah, you might be holding your breath, but those guys on the defensive side of the ball, they've got big smiles on their faces. He's handing out picks like the people just leave the candy out at Halloween, and you take what you want. They're having a blast out there playing against him today.
And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to. The Falcons send out their punter. He'll boot it away from about his 35. And this will be taken at the 13. It's just a 32-yard punt with no return. And the Panthers will have a first and 10 from deep in their own territory. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline? Well, partner, they're not content to run this one out as we head towards the half, trying to hit a big chunk play right there and add to their score.
Yeah, this is a confident group. At the very least, they're thinking field goal.
Yeah, and I don't blame them one bit. I don't think you sit on the ball going into the half when you have a chance to put some more points on the board.
And just not a ton of room to work with. He'll get it to the 15 for a gain of 2. On third down, he'll drop to throw. He'll rifle this one deep right side.
And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in.
That might be the third down stop that they needed, because they've had a lot of trouble slowing down this offense in the first half. This might be their opportunity to get off the field.
Now on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And with 8 seconds on the clock, really not a lot of time to try to put anything together.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Trying to lay one up deep. And incomplete on the deep ball.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far. But on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. That's going to be caught by Pitts. And he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
And here on the road, that could be a huge score for their morale in the second half.
Every team has confidence going into the start of games, but sometimes you get it rocked a little bit, and it certainly applies here for them. But guess what? Just what you said, this touchdown can give them their belief back that they can win in the second half.
So it's half. Well, anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. It'll be Falcons football, and they trail here as we get back underway on EA Sports. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And they trail here to begin the second half. What's going to be a key for them to get back in the game?
I think they're right there, and I think this game is still up for the taking for them because we always talk about turnovers. They had two of them in the first half, and once you start talking about if you have three, four, or five, you know it's beyond difficult to try and win a football game with that. Those have to be eliminated. If they take care of the ball, they've still got a shot.
And now here is another interception. A great read, and it's picked off. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line. Tough one there. First drive of the third quarter, throw an interception, and now a chance that they could be an even a bigger hole if they can convert this into points.
Yeah, but how good do you feel if you're that defensive coordinator right now? Because you just know that the head coach looked at him and said, turn him loose, big man. And he'd be able to take a few extra chances playing with this type of a lead, and boy, it paid off.
Well, defensively, you're over there trying to catch your breath and trying not to show the offense that you're a little bit fatigued. You're right back out there after the turnover. Now they've got to work towards getting another couple of stops and forcing them into at least a long field goal situation.
On second down, McCaffrey. McCaffrey with a first down and more. And finally, taken down at the 15. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Cameron Curl. And the Falcons are going to take possession here as they've got it at their own four-yard line. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. Seven picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offense coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
And boy, another ill-advised throw there as that will wind up incomplete.
When you're backed up this deep, sometimes defenses sacrifice coverage for pass rush because they know you can only go so far on your pass drop. You've got the back of the end zone. So they came after him. He took the shot downfield. He didn't connect, but boy, that was force against force.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. From deep in their own territory, they look to throw. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 14. And they will take over with a football just outside of the 10 at the 12-yard line. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Touchdown! A great play there. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Panthers use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead now up to 14. kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Now a first down run is going nowhere. He's going to be dropped in the backfield, a loss of two.
I see a shake of the head as he gets up, and you've got to imagine he's thinking, guys, you got to help me out. He's hoping his team can read his thoughts, because he definitely needs some assistance.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. Yeah, he's just throwing the ball up for grabs now. Fortunately, that one going to fall incomplete. We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. And the defense coming through on third down. A loss of seven to bring up fourth. They're going to try and throw. And now here's another interception. Picked off by J.C. Horn. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line. And that gives him now three interceptions in the game.
Well, someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. When was the last time we had someone get three in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. A great effort there with touchdown number seven on the year. And the Panthers use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. Point after try forthcoming. And he's been a busy man. Five for five now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. It's a squibber picked up around the 27. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily that you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for them. Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off right around the 43. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. And now here's a carry heading left. Good cover defensively as they get to him just beyond the 45 after the broken tackle. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's over midfield and into Falcon territory. They'll look to throw for it on third and one. Flush to his right. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. They'll try and throw for it here. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the Falcons will take control of the football in great field position. A good start to the drive here as that's caught out on the left side. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. A big play there on the catch and run.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. A great play there. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Falcons cut into that lead. So remember now, this was all set up by the stop defensively on fourth down. That's what got them this great field position. And then two plays later, they're already in the end zone.
Yeah, partner, funny how it works like that, huh? That's a momentum swing amusement park style. Your defense comes off the field, bouncing, grooving. They're fired up. And it carries over to the other side of the ball.
Extra point right down the middle. And the lead will be cut down to 14. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Here's Christian McCaffrey to return it. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. Mike Tomlin has reached for that red challenge flag, and he'll throw it out there. So the decision to challenge does not pan out, and that's also going to cost him a timeout. And he'll be stopped at the 35, but not before he picks up 7 yards. Back to throw here. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Finally, a good play there defensively on the deep ball. The secondary has had its struggles this entire game. Offensively, they've had their way with them.
They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. He's going to go up top again. And got his man complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. That's going to be caught. Touchdown, Panthers. A great effort there. His second touchdown of the night. And the Panthers are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter. The point after is good, and the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They're down three touchdowns to this point, needing to put something together as they have it first and 10. He's going to air one out, and that one incomplete. They try to sneak in a deep ball with the clock running down, but to no avail as time will expire on this third quarter of play. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And this one is incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. They'll look to throw. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about, and you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
And that is incomplete, but there is a flag. And on fourth down, this is a big call. So a big chunk of yardage will be marked off there for that PI call.
And now you know why receivers and the guys throwing the ball, they like to collaborate and just heave it up sometimes, because you can get these types of calls that go against the defense. Pass interference, and they gain over 30 yards of real estate on that one.
At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense, they're just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them, because just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
The Falcons on third down. They've struggled to the tune of 2 for 8 so far. This is third and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. And now here's another interception. Adrian Amos with a pick. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line. Gosh, you add up last week and this week now. That's 9 interceptions in this 2-game stretch, and we're not done here.
It's almost as if they can't even believe their eyes. Or maybe, partner, is the confidence level in him so high that they believe he'll get out of it and make plays for them to win a game?
Well, they've said they believe in him. That's being tested right here. Gonna throw deep for the end zone. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. A great play there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Panthers add on to their lead, and it's looking like that win streak is gonna extend another week. Extra point splits the uprights, and that'll increase their lead to 28. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Taking it about the 1. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on now here in this fourth quarter. Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Here comes the blitz as they look to throw. And that one almost intercepted. Could have been his 3rd pick of the game. Instead, it's going to bring up a 3rd down. On play action, they'll throw. He's going to let this one go deep. And my goodness, another interception. Jeremy Chin picks it off. And the Panthers are going to take possession here at their own 47-yard line. Going to give this time to the tailback. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it. play action fake. They'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. This pass caught by Hamler. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. They'll look to throw here. Eluding the pressure. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. It'll go as nearly a loss of 10 on first and goal. So a disaster there. It goes as a 9-yard loss on the sack.
Well, there's still time to rectify this situation.
And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. A great effort there. His third touchdown of the game, number 9 on the season. And the Panthers are on their way to a 9-0 start as they build on to their lead. Point after, right down the middle. And that will extend this big lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. From just... Oh, a miscommunication on the lateral. The ball's out. So a teammate picking him up there, that was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy, because you want to make sure that the catch is secure. And a lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy. Okay, you're responsible for making sure he secures the catch. He's not always the one that makes the recovery, but he can always sound out the alarm. Hey, ball's on the ground. We've got to get it back.
Second and 11. That's caught left side to tight end Pitts. And he'll be taken down, but they've got this one up to the 35-yard line. A big play that time on the catch and run.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They can go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them.
And now here's another interception. Jeremy Chinn picks it off. Charles, are you kidding me? 4 interceptions? I mean, that's a good season for a lot of defensive backs.
A lot of reason to get voted into the Pro Bowl. When you have 4-1 game, I mean, talk about a campaign slogan, right? I got 4. Send me to the Pro Bowl, guys. What a game we've experienced watching this one.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Looking to throw. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete. 4th quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you can put yourself in jeopardy.
The offense going to stay out there. They've converted once, failed once. What can they do here on 4th down? And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. On 1st down, he'll drop to throw. Throw left side. McCaffrey's got it. And they are going to score. Touchdown as they just add to their totals.
Well, business as usual for them. Well on their way to another victory. Riding a serious wave of momentum from what we've seen. And so far, they haven't met their match. So if you're going to play this team in the future, your mission is clear. You better be ready to play and match their firepower.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Taken at the goal line. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the 4th quarter. This would be their 3rd straight defeat. Now here's a pass on 1st down that's knocked away and incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. They'll set up a throw. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. The safety blitz staged to perfection that time as they sack him for a loss of 6. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 18. And he'll be marked down at the 2-yard line. Yet another mistake after the interception there. And gosh, you look up at the scoreboard, they just got to be thinking this one cannot get over fast enough.
It certainly can't. And also what happens when you get this big of a depth.
And the pressure gets there. He'll go down. It's a sack. And it is going to bring us to the two-minute warning. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. They've got a second and goal now as they look to add a few more points here onto their total. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. They'll set up to throw. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. Now for the point after. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This fielded right at the goal line. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case. There's too much to handle on the other side in this one. Well, they'll run it here on the jet sweep. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. He'll drop to throw. And now here's another interception. Jeremy Chin picks it off. And they will finally put it into the return, but not until he takes it back all the way inside the 10-yard line. Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. And he's brought down right at the 5-yard line. Give him 2 on the play. And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. That one looks like he'll throw here. And this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown. Now the try here for the point after. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Taking it about the 1. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up 3rd down. Now back to throw. And that was almost intercepted. Boy, he's got 2 already, nearly a 3rd, but not to be, and it's 4th down. And how about this? 4th and long, and they're going to go for it. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And give him another 6. It's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues. Extra point attempt to come here. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. It's a squibber picked up. Now a hit and a loose football. And a penalty marker's down on the field. And they might be backing up a bit here to start the drive. Yeah, this is going to put them back with a not great field position.
So they really got zero benefit at all, right? Sometimes you can absorb a penalty when you get a big return. Then the penalty brings it back, but you still have great field position. As you pointed out, not in this case.
A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Panthers, the train just keeps rolling. 9-0 now to start this campaign. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for the Falcons, their season is on life support somewhat now at 3-6. And they'll try to make amends next week as they host the New Orleans Saints.
Started from the gutter. Started like no one stunned. She curved me back then, came back, so I swung.